Welcome back to Ask a Scientist. I'm your host, Kerbens, and today we'll be turning to our polar bear expert, Dr. Evan Richardson. We asked you what you wanted to know, and you responded. Aimé and Ophélie were both curious to know about the dangers that polar bears are facing today.
My name is Aimé, I'm from Ottawa. I wonder how many polar bears are out there in the world, and what kind of dangers are they facing now?
Is climate change really impacting polar bears?
Those are wonderful questions. Over to you, Evan.
Great questions. Scientists currently estimate that there are approximately 25,000 polar bears across the circumpolar Arctic, inhabiting areas of the United States, Russia, Norway, Greenland, and Canada. Canada is home to approximately two-thirds of the world's polar bears due to our unique northern geography. Polar bears face many threats in our rapidly changing world, including contaminants in the Arctic food web, threats from oil and gas development, shipping, tourism, and the long-term threat of climate change. Which brings us to our next question. Does climate change affect polar bears? In order to answer that question, we first need to understand a little bit about polar bear ecology. Polar bears are a sea ice dependent species. They rely on the sea ice as a platform from which to hunt their primary prey, ring seals and bearded seals. Without the sea ice, bears are simply not fast enough in the open water to catch their prey. What this means is that the duration of sea ice influences the amount of time the bears have to feed in any given year. What we've seen with long-term climate warming is the amount of time bears have feeding is declining, and the amount of time they spend living off their stored body reserves is increasing. So how does this affect polar bears? Well, it really comes down to a very simple equation, and that's energy in equals energy out. Bears can allocate energy to growth, movement, reproduction, and survival, but when we start to change the amount of energy bears take in, they have to reallocate their energy to those various competing demands. What we've seen as part of long-term research programs here at Environment and Climate Change Canada is when the sea ice melts early and forms later in the fall, polar bear body condition declines as well as survival, ultimately influencing the viability of populations. As a part of this research, as well as research from our colleagues across the circumpolar Arctic, climate-mediated declines in the availability of sea ice habitat has been deemed the greatest conservation threat to polar bears. Thanks, and back to you, Kerbens.
Thank you, Dr. Richardson. Polar bears certainly don't have it easy. What would you like to know? Send us your questions and keep watching Ask a Scientist. See you next time.